Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part first of Azure DevOps Engineer series. Question number one, you are configuring project matrices for dashboards in Azure DevOps. You need to configure a chart widget that measures the elapsed time to complete work items once they become active. Means elapsed time calculation after activation of the work item. Which of the following is the widget you should use? We are in Azure DevOps portal and we have one organization created here. Under one organization, we have one project, Azure Wala. Under the Azure Wala project, we have overview tab and we do have dashboards here. We can add the widget from here. Let's learn about these charts in detail. Before we learn about charts, let's understand about the terminologies being used to measure the time. The task activities move in this flow. First of all, we do have work item in backlog and that goes to the proposed stage. Then it goes in the progress and it becomes active and then it is marked completed. So in Agile, first status is new, then the active, then resolved, and then closed. In Scrum methodology, it is marked new, approved, committed, and done. In CMMI, it is called proposed, active, resolved, and closed. When the task is active in any of the methodology and marked completed, that duration is called cycle time. When the task is created or work item is created, and after the creation of that work item till the completion of that work item is called lead time. Now first we'll discuss about cumulative flow diagram. This is a cumulative flow diagram and on x-axis we get the time and on y-axis we get the count of work items with their status. So on day 0 we'll get all the work items as scope change, and as day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4 passes, these items become active. So on first day some of the items are taken or activated by developer and developer is actively working on this. On second day little more, third day little more, on fourth day little more. So it's adding up the active items and the change item definitely reducing because these are taken from here to here only. So similarly it will go, let's say, fifth day, sixth day, seventh day, and eighth day, and these items will start getting resolved. So as time passes, more and more resolved items start accumulating. Once these items are resolved, these are marked closed, means these are confirmed by the customer, and items, closed items, number of closed items will start increasing. But here these items are count of work items. The count of work items are calculated against the time. So there is nothing about the elapsed time. There is nothing about the cycle time. Therefore, from cumulative flow diagram, we do not get any information about cycle time and elapsed time. Let's see the next option. A burn-up chart is a type of chart that tracks the progress of a project by showing the amount of work completed over time. So on x-axis we do have time and on y-axis the completed work. So on day 1, for example, we have little bit of work which is completed. On day 2 it accumulates more. On day 3, 4, etc. it accumulates more and more work. So every day we are adding up more and more completed work to a project against the time. And on top, if you can see here, we got the average burn up, means on daily basis we are completing 2 tasks. The burn up chart displays the completed task user story or bugs finished on every day and against the time. The burn up chart doesn't give us any information about lead time or cycle time which is taken to complete the task. So option B is incorrect in this case. Let's go to option D. A burn down chart is a type of chart that tracks the remaining work. As we have seen in burn up chart, it talks about completed work, and in burn down chart it talks about remaining work over time. So on x-axis we do have time, and on y-axis we have number of tasks or story point or bugs. The yellow line represents the total amount of work in the backlog, and it is little bit increasing because work is being added in the backlog while time is passing or sprints are going on. So on sprint 1 or day 1 we were having a lot of work which was remaining, and this amount of work is completed by the second sprint. The slope is downwards because the remaining work is getting less and less, but it doesn't give any information about lead time or cycle time taken by task or story. Therefore, this will not be the correct answer. Now let's discuss the cycle time chart, or it could be for lead time as well. But in our case, we are going to discuss the cycle time. It is against the time and it is for dates. Y-axis represents the time or elapsed time to complete the task. So for example, in our case, we can see on this specific day, we have certain tasks have taken longer time to complete. And in these cases, it is the shorter time and more tasks. Larger dots represent multiple work items. So if we do have larger dots and less time is taken, means the multiple work item got completed in less time. If we have any dot on higher side, means it has taken the longer time to complete. If the size of the dot is small, it means there are few number of work items completed in longer period of time. But if the dot size is larger, like this one, and have taken relatively more time to complete, this would be the correct chart to measure the elapsed time from the activation of the task to completion. Let's go back to question. Therefore, the cycle time widget is the correct answer. Cumulative flow diagram gives us the count of work items, therefore it is not correct. Burn up diagram also gives us the completed task count items, therefore it is not correct. And burn down diagram gives us the remaining task count items. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.